Hi everyone, in this video we are going to talk about how to define if-else and also if-elif-else for lambda functions in Python programming language. So please stay tuned. So first of all, consider this normal function and we want to convert this normal function into a lambda function. So you can see that this function, which is called g, takes an input parameter which is x, and if x is less than or equal to 10, it returns x times 2, and otherwise it returns x times 3. So first of all, we should type lambda because you want to define a lambda function, and the input parameter is x, and we should put a semicolon, and after semicolon we should type what is the output. And remember, before the semicolon is the input and after the semicolon is the output. So if we want to return x times 2 if x is less than or equal to 10, and else we want to return x times 3. There it is. And for example, we want to name this lambda function f. So here, if I print f8, which you can see that 8 is less than or equal to 10, and it is going to return x times 2, I mean 16. So if I run the code, you can see that the output is 16. But if we pass 20 to this f function, because this else is true, it is going to return x times 3. So it is going to return 60. So if I run the code, you can see that the output is 60. So let's talk about how to define if, elif, and else for lambda functions in Python programming language. So consider this function, which is called g. It takes an input parameter, which is x. And if the input parameter is equal to 0, it is going to return 0. Else if the input parameter is less than 0, it is going to return minus 1. And otherwise, it is going to return positive 1. So we simply type lambda x semicolon. So we want to return 0 if the input parameter, which is x, is equal to 0. And otherwise, I mean else, we have two conditions. So we open a parenthesis. So here we are going to return minus 1 if x is less than 0, and otherwise we are going to return positive 1. So in order to have if, elif, and else, you should have a structure like this. So we are saying we want to return 0 if x is equals to 0. Otherwise, we have two conditions. If x is less than 0, we are going to return minus 1. And otherwise, I mean, if the else is true, we're going to return positive 1. So suppose that we want to name the function f. And here, for example, if I print f of 5, you can see that the output is positive 1. If I print f minus 8, you can see that the result is minus 1. And if I print f of 0, you can see that the output is 0.